Like Jenny is the great. Like Katt Williams the mediocre.
Oh man, DC is always remarkable. It doesn't matter when you come, how you come, DC is always the business.
Where is your self-esteem? It's not that bad, boo-boo. This is for all of the people listening to me right now who do not have a silver spoon in their mouth. It's okay. Rusty forks get the job done too, boo-boo. This is for all my niggas in the struggle whose body is 60% water and 20% top ramen salt packet. Get your grind on, my nigga. Get your grind on. It's okay.
Life is short. You better enjoy what you got. Yep. Stop being ungrateful all the goddamn time.
This is Money Mike on Friday after next. Wildin' out. Pimp Chronicles, American Hustle First Sunday. DC, get on your motherfucking feet and give it up.
Saying that I chose this cutie pie with whom I wanna be. And I apologize if this message gets you down. Then I CC'd every girl that I CC round on. To choose it, never without a rubber. Never in the streets like it on top of the cover. Money on the dresser, drive a compressor. Top notch, get the most, not the lesser. Trash like the people, $40 in the club.
Because it's beautiful, and y'all really do have some historical, wonderful places to look at. What you don't find out till you're actually in D.C. is that while you're looking at this, D.C. is actually behind you, and D.C. look like this. What's going on, my niggas?
D.C.
Nothing fucking like it. I'm so happy to be here. Your motherfuckers have been wonderful. Before I get started, what a motherfucking pleasure it is with all the hating going on in the world to be surrounded by this many real motherfuckers at one goddamn time. It is certainly a pleasure. Certainly a fucking pleasure. It's so much going on in the world right now, and I need to say to real motherfuckers, you're gonna have to be a little bit more selfish. In 2008, you're not selfish enough. Motherfuckers go all day trying to please other people and shit, and you forget you got to please your star player, the motherfucker that's in the mirror looking at you every goddamn day. That need to be the motherfucker you concerned about. Nigga, how are you doing today? Nigga, fuck what they talking about. You, some of y'all is mean to yourself, say terrible shit to yourself. I lie to me every morning in the mirror, just ridiculous lies to make me feel better. Just, nigga, did you catch a growth spurt last night, nigga? You look like you could be 5'5" today, nigga. This is a tall day for you. You better say some shit in 2008 to motivate your motherfucking self, because if you a real motherfucker, they hate you with every fucking thing they got. They can't stand it. They hate what you look like, what you're wearing, what you're driving, what you talk about, what you think about. They fucking hate it, and you gonna have to understand that's the way it is. Have you ever caught a motherfucker looking at you with, I just caught the stomach virus face? You ever just out your peripheral just caught a motherfucker just... like everything about you really fuck with them. That's what the fuck is supposed to happen. You gotta remember to laugh in 2008. You ain't gotta wait for a joke. The hater is the goddamn joke. Soon as you see that motherfucker, you supposed to laugh immediately. I know why you mad, nigga. I know why you mad. It might be bugs on the rest of you mugs, but it ain't no bugs on me. I know why you're mad, nigga. You gonna have to be happy and be in tune with your star player, because these motherfuckers is on some bullshit. If you watch TV, all they want to talk about is the election. The election, it's time for a new president. I think first we need to celebrate the fact that Bush ain't gonna be president no goddamn more. First. This motherfucker. I don't understand. How the fuck do you get a job and fuck up everything? Everything. This motherfucker has fucked up everything. Gas, water, air, everything. And he's not just stupid. Bush don't even give a fuck. He won't even try. At least if you stupid, you should try. He don't even try. I don't even know why he go to the press conference. He don't even be talking about shit they even be talking about. They just, what do you think about the problem in Darfur? You get on that horse, you gotta ride it. Him about a goddamn horse. Then he walk off like he done really said some shit. This motherfucker don't give a shit. Bush done led this country lost for 8 goddamn years. For 8 fucking years, we've been not finding the same one motherfucker we was looking for in the first place. The same one motherfucker. Not a gang, not a group, not a country. The same one motherfucker. The tall one with the beard and the robes and the kidney problem and the dialysis machine lived in a cave doing a video right now. We still ain't found that same one motherfucker, but they know everything T.I. did at the Hip Hop Awards. They got that shit down in 5-minute increments. Just 9 o'clock, 9:05, 9:10, 9:15, 9. I don't know why that said 9:10. Some of you niggas couldn't wait. That dumbass nigga said 9:10. That's not even a real time, that nigga said. Bush's motherfucking ass, he don't give a shit. Every time you see our soldiers, they tired as shit from marching in the wrong goddamn direction. Every time you see them, just... Y'all going the wrong way. We know. Well, no shit. 2 weeks ago on CNN, they said Pakistan is terror central. Pakistan? That's not what the fuck you motherfuckers said, Pakistan. You said Afghanistan. Then you said Iran, then Iraq, then Syria, then Baghdad. You motherfuckers have no idea where terror is, do you? And why the fuck is we chasing terror if terror can't even keep a home address? Maybe terror ain't doing well right now. But Bush don't give a fuck. He don't give a fuck. And white people, y'all too nice. Just let a motherfucker fuck up the greatest country for 8 years in a fucking row. White people, you just let the driver of the car be lost for miles and miles and miles, and they won't even say nothing. Just sit in the back seat and talk shit quietly to each other and shit. I don't think they even know where they're going. No, because we passed that 3 times, remember? I took a picture with my camera phone. You do remember. As niggas, we ain't got no patience. You can't even be the lost driver of niggas, because we ain't got enough patience. Soon as your ass make 2 suspect lefts, your ass is no longer the goddamn driver. Niggas ain't got no patience. If one nigga in the back go, hey, you gotta pull this motherfucker over, nigga. You can't be the driver if you don't know where the fuck you going. We got warrants back here, nigga. We can't be lost just looking around. Bush's motherfucking ass. He don't give a shit. He think he can just go over there and fuck with all the countries that got brown people in it, then come back over here to America like everything gonna be okay. Everything ain't gonna be okay. You can ask a nigga. You can go in the club and say fuck everybody in the club, but you cannot then walk back to your car. I keep trying to tell you. Go ahead, try it. Fuck fuck everybody in the club. Now go back to your car. Wait for it. The fuck I was trying to tell you. And now it's time for a new president. And all they want us to do is pick a new president. I feel like, didn't we just get out of a fucked up relationship? Maybe we don't need a president right now. Can we be single as a country for a while and maybe date a president, see how that work out for a couple months? This shit is bullshit. I've been confused the whole goddamn election. I've been confused. Because everybody commercial sound good at 2:30 in the goddamn morning, and you done had a rough day and shit. They just, do you care about your family? Yes, I do. Is healthcare important to you? Well, yes, it is. No, nigga, this motherfucker know me personally. This ain't no regular campaign. This motherfucker's in my family life. I've been confused the whole goddamn election. Before Barack came along, I was excited about Hillary. I thought it was gonna be a good thing for us to have a woman in the office. I felt like at least if we had a woman president, we wouldn't have to worry about what other countries was doing, because bitch gonna be on espionage on day one. That's gonna be her first shit. You know I got China's voicemail messages today, right? I'm gonna get the MySpace password by 10:30. Give me a second, bitch. It's my first day. But then Hillary came and started acting cocky for no goddamn reason. Like, she should have been president all goddamn ready. Like, you motherfuckers need to Google me. I've been running countries before this. She can't stand Barack's good talking ass. Every time that nigga say something clever, she just... I don't know what Hillary was thinking. She thought she was just gonna inherit the minority vote. Like, she was just gonna get the nigga vote off top. Wait a minute, bitch, we don't know you like that. No, bitch, we like your husband. We like your husband. That's not the same thing. You wasn't even on the invitation. It said Bill Clinton plus one. We didn't know who he was gonna bring. I was voting for Monica for no goddamn reason. I thought she was coming back. I'm just saying, you can't think niggas forget. Niggas don't forget. Last time I checked, you wasn't handling the presidential penis correctly. So I'm trying to figure out, if you can't handle a dick, bitch, how you gonna handle the world? That's a big place, I'm just saying. Fuck that, that was your main missile to look after. That was Air Force One you let fly the fuck off. How the fuck? I've been confused the whole goddamn election. When it comes to Barack, white people, I know it's not fair, but y'all need to just give us a minute just to be proud for a goddamn second. Can we just be proud? Shit. This is history. You selfish motherfuckers. White people, ain't y'all had all the goddamn presidents? Go to the library and get the president book. White. Give me the vice presidents. White. Niggas ain't never even had a chance. Some niggas still don't believe it. Just, nigga, I think I saw Tiger Woods running for president on SportsCenter, nigga. He had on his green jacket and everything. That nigga's a winner. He really is. I don't know. White people, I don't think you should vote for somebody just because of their race. But I will say, if you was ever going to vote for a nigga, if you was ever going to vote for a nigga, this is the nigga to vote for right here. This is the one. Yes. Absolutely. Because he is nigga light. This nigga been running for 2 years. He ain't had no baby mama come out the woodwork. This nigga don't owe nobody $200 for nothing. He ain't never had a pit bull puppy. Don't have an earring. Never had a tattoo. Where the fuck did you get this nigga from? A cave in Salt Lake City, some goddamn where? This nigga's like a black superhero. This nigga's amazing. I believe he can fly. Thank God for Michelle Obama. That's a real nigga. Barack may be a clone, but Michelle Obama is a thoroughbred nigga. You can look right on TV and tell that's a real nigga. You know, if you walk up on her in person, she smell like Motions hair conditioner and cocoa butter. That's a real nigga right there. Somebody go to Jeremiah Wright's church and tell him to shut the fuck up while we trying to make some goddamn progress. Niggas were so embarrassed. Oh, nigga, don't fuck it up yet. God damn. I've been confused the whole fucking election. I'm just glad Huckabee had to drop out the goddamn race, because I was finna leave the goddamn country if we had to have a president named motherfucking Huckabee. That's where we should draw the goddamn line. We can't go from a Bush to a motherfucking Huckabee all in the same goddamn junk. Have all the other countries fucking with us at the United Nations and shit. Just, you are with Huckabee, yes? You are followers of Huckabee, yes? How the fuck you gonna be president? Your name sound like bullshit weed. Nigga, don't even come over here with that big ass bag of Huckabee, nigga. Ain't nobody interested in that shit. Like smoking a cactus. Some of you niggas can't even laugh because you got a big ass bag of Huckabee in your pocket right now. Just, McCain can't be president because he 111. I'm sorry, I know it ain't fair, but goddammit, you can't be the president during a time of change and you might have a diaper that's time to change. That's just, that shit don't even go together. Fuck that. At 111, you got too many fucked up memories of niggas, first of all. You'd be done fucked around and had a flashback at 111. What is your last name? I think I used to own your grandfather. What is your last name? Did you hear what that motherfucker said to Condoleezza Rice? He can't be president. Fuck that. His memory can't be good at 111. I got an uncle that's 67. We don't let that nigga drive after 7 o'clock p.m. because he'll forget he driving everybody and jump out to go pee and leave the car running right down the street and shit. McCain, 111. He been lost the military or some shit. It's time for war. He just wake up. Where's the army? Everybody waiting on the army in Baghdad. He done sent everybody to Southeast Berry Farms for no goddamn reason. Too much motherfucking shit going on. It's my motherfucking point. It's too much fucking shit going on. That's why you gonna have to make a dedication to yourself that you gonna treat your star player a little bit nicer in 2008. Some of us go through our whole life trying to please other motherfuckers and you can't please nobody. People in your family mad, people at your job mad, people in your car mad, everybody mad. Fuck that. How the fuck are you doing, nigga? How are you doing? You might want to focus on that a little bit motherfucking more in 2008, especially if you a real motherfucker, because these motherfuckers hate real motherfuckers. If you a real motherfucker, understand they hate every goddamn thing about you. These motherfuckers hate real motherfuckers. I'm gonna give you a prime fucking example. They supposed to be putting medicine in America to help motherfuckers feel better and help you live better. But these motherfuckers don't give a fuck about the medicine. They out making their motherfucking money. They give you one medication supposed to fix some shit and the side effect fuck up your leg and shit. Then they give you another one to fix that and it fuck up your arm and now you on two medications looking like a flamingo in front of your motherfucking children and shit. These motherfuckers don't give a fuck. Just 1 month, they say this is the best medicine ever. It'll cure everything. And then 3 months later, you hear this quiet ass commercial. Have you or one of your loved ones been killed from using our medicine? Dial 1-800-R-BAD. That's 1-800. Ah, bad. These motherfuckers don't give a fuck. Weed is still illegal and all of their shit is still fucked up. Their medication either don't work or it worked too fucking good. And I wasn't familiar with working too good and I had to find out the hard way. I got a son that's 7, his name Malik. This nigga run every goddamn day. That's what the fuck he do. You ain't gotta chase him, you ain't gotta train him, you ain't gotta put shorts on him. This nigga is ready every morning. Soon as his foot touched the goddamn ground, out the bed, shoo! That nigga's gone for the rest of the goddamn day. Shoo, 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 shoo. You either see him like this or like that. That's your only two options. Shoo, 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 shoo. And he be happy as shit. Now, the nurse at the school say, she say, it's not healthy. I said, you don't understand, the nigga's happy. She said, no, you don't understand. Whether he's happy or not, it's not healthy. I said, now I don't know what the fuck you want me to do. The nigga, I can't put the nigga in trouble for being happy. That's kind of, nigga, stop being happy and get in there and be miserable. I can't fucking do it. So I said, what do you recommend? So she recommended Ritalin. Now, she told me the shit was gonna even him out. Now either I don't know what the fuck even means, or Ritalin got crack cocaine in it, one of the two, is a goddamn fact, because this shit is no bullshit. I wasn't ready. He wasn't ready. This shit caught both of us off guard. I gave the nigga the shit in the kitchen. He was on the way to his room. That nigga never even made it out the hallway. That shit caught that nigga in mid-stride. He was just... Now, for the first 2 hours, I was happy as shit. I'm getting shit done. I'm like, this is wonderful. But after 3 hours, you got to come check on the nigga now after 3 hours. Nigga, what you doing? My kid's smart ass. I'm being good like you want it, daddy. Okay, touche, my nigga, touche, touche. This would fuck me up. I was like, you've been sitting there for 3 hours. What are you thinking about? That nigga said, running? Well, go on and run then, little nigga. Go on and run. Because you just going to have to let real shit be real shit. Because these motherfuckers are attacking real shit at every motherfucking angle. They had a story on CNN 3 weeks ago that said the USDA has approved the sale of clone meat to the American public. What? See, I was high when I originally saw the story. So I waited all the way till I came down to relook at the story, and it still fucking said the USDA has approved the sale of clone meat to the American public. Ain't that about a god? You raggedy motherfuckers would feed. You gonna feed? We saw the movie Multiplicity. We know what the fuck clone mean, motherfucker. It mean retarded. You gonna feed us the retarded ass clone cow meat now? And I thought niggas was gonna tear up the streets and riot and shit, and nothing fucking happened. You, these motherfuckers, you gonna feed America the clone? Ain't it motherfuckers starving in other countries that we could have gave the goddamn retarded clone meat to first to see if that was gonna work out? They ain't got shit to eat. They don't give a fuck. You can't feed it to us first, you motherfuckers. And some of you same niggas gonna be eating the shit out that goddamn clone meat and talking shit about, nigga, fuck that, nigga. The clone meat is delicious, nigga. They put the garlic in the cow as a baby, nigga. You ain't even gotta season it. It just already grow up garlic and delicious, nigga. They don't give a fuck about us. You know the clone meat gonna be cheap as shit. Nigga, fuck that. I went to McDonald's, got the McClone combo for 19 cents, nigga. Had 11 big-ass Big Macs in it. It was wonderful. That's all right. That's all right. Go ahead. Go ahead. No, go ahead. Feed your baby the retarded-ass clone cow meat and see what the fuck happened. You gonna be wondering why your daughter's 4 years old, weighs 611 pounds, got a little horn coming out her motherfucking braids, and the bitch can't do her alphabet correctly. Just A, B, C, D, Then you fed that bitch the retarded-ass cow meat. These motherfuckers don't give a fuck. That's why you gonna have to be in tune with your star fucking player. These motherfuckers put so much bullshit on the news. If you watch the news, you would think steroids is the drug problem in America. I've been all across this great country buying drugs and shit. I have never ran into a steroid salesman. Have one of you niggas ever ran into one just, oh, you know I got them fire in them roids, nigga. I got them fire in them roids. Nigga, if you got hemorrhoids, you shouldn't be selling weed right now to you. Fuck, they fuck up steroids. Steroids are supposed to be the perfect goddamn drug. Now they got Roger Clemens all on TV talking about he ain't on steroids. He can say he ain't on steroids, but what he can't do is not look big as fuck on TV while he's saying it. That motherfucker's huge.
Senator, I was never on steroids. Senator, I was never on steroids. I just got bigger and stronger the older I got.
What you get for talking so goddamn much. That's why Barry Bonds is still a goddamn G, because Barry ain't say shit. They couldn't stand that motherfucker. Every time they asked him another question, he just hit another home run. They was mad as shit. Just, Barry, are you on steroids?
No comment.
They was mad as shit at that motherfucker. I don't know how they fucked up steroids. Steroids supposed to be the perfect goddamn drug. Do you know how excited a nigga my size was to hear about a human growth hormone, nigga? I thought Jesus had answered this prayer individually. I was glued to the TV. Thank you, Jesus, for finally coming through. I appreciate that. I knew you weren't gonna let me look like a seventh grader the rest of my life. I really did know. Fuck what y'all talking about. I was gonna be the first nigga on steroids. I'm gonna have to be the biggest nigga in comedy one way or the goddamn other. At 5'5", 1,246 pounds of comedy, and I'm coming out in a fur coat and biker shorts so you niggas can't act like I ain't big as shit. I was all motherfucking excited about steroids. I was like, well, what's the side effect? They was like, it make your dick litter. Make your dick litter? Ain't no motherfucking side effect. That's from Satan. What the fuck are you talking about? A side effect. It make you big and make your dick little? Ain't that? I was trying to get the muscles to get some more pussy. I wasn't trying to trick a bitch. That's just wrong. Come on in here, bitch. I'm huge. You see I'm huge? Come on. Bing. Nothing. I apologize. But fuck me anyway, but feel my arms. You feel how big my arms are, don't you? Do you feel that? Motherfuckers fucked up everything. That's why I'm saying if you a real motherfucker, you just gonna have to hold on to the fact you a real motherfucker because it's getting ready to change. It ain't just about color no more. They hate all real motherfuckers. I'm gonna give you a prime example. There's a white boy that ran track for a motherfucking living. He ran track for a motherfucking living, and he lost both his motherfucking legs. Now, I hate losers and quitters, but I feel like if you run for a motherfucking living and you lose both of your motherfucking legs, you should be allowed to sit this motherfucker out. You have done everything there was for you to do. And this motherfucker on some gangster shit decide not only is he gonna walk again, he decide he gonna fucking race again. Now you got to be in tune with your fucking star player to pull this shit off, cause they made him some aluminum racing legs and shit look like bent back paper clips and shit. Just don't try to act like something wrong with me. Some of you motherfuckers saw the story. You know what the fuck I'm talking about. It looked like bent back paper clips, like two baby boomerangs and shit. That's what he had to run on. That motherfucker had to be in tune with his star fucking player, because sometimes motherfuckers ain't gonna have your back like you think you should. And this motherfucker now gotta come in on his aluminum racing legs and race again. And he gotta try to come in and be all calm and smooth and not draw too much attention to himself. To tink, 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 tink. Motherfuckers fucking with him and shit. Yeah, you gotta go over there and sign up first before you race. Okay, motherfucker. Tink, 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 tink. Yeah, they said I gotta sign up first. It's no sign up at all. Tink, 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 tink. He all at the starting line, you know motherfuckers fucking with him, doing all sorts of unnecessary exercises with their legs and shit, just on your mark. Tink, 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 tink. And the craziest fucking thing happened. This motherfucker not only started running, this motherfucker started winning. And you know a hater can't stand a goddamn winner. And the last place you wanna be in a motherfucking foot race is behind the motherfucker with no goddamn foots. That's the last. I bet that motherfucker's as mad as shit. My legs tired. Ain't your legs tired? His legs ain't tired. He just tink, 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 tink. Just paper clips and sparks everywhere. Just tink, 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 tink. But you gonna have to be in tune with your star fucking player, because these haters do not play fair. These hating ass motherfuckers at the Olympic Committee let this motherfucker race and then waited till he won and then disqualified him and said, and I quote, he had an unfair advantage. Are you talking about the motherfucker running with no goddamn legs? Is that who the fuck you talking about? Poor little Tink Tink. Think about that when you think you having a bad goddamn day. Poor little Tink Tink, ain't that a bitch? That's why you gonna have to be in tune with your star fucking player. These motherfuckers want you to be miserable. They want you to be sad. They want you to feel like they feel. You can't feel like the fuck they feel because you ain't like them. You gonna have to get every fucking laugh you can possibly get. Fuck what they talk about. They want you to be sad because they sad. Fuck that. You gotta be happy. If a motherfucker fall in front of you in 2000 goddamn 8 and you are not a doctor on duty across the street from the hospital, it is your obligation to get 7 laughs off that motherfucker before he get off the ground. Call another nigga so he can get 4-5 in. You gonna have to, because they want you to be miserable. I laugh at shit I'm not even supposed to laugh at. I'll laugh first and apologize after. Like, when they was talking about the polygamy ranch and they had them all on TV before they showed them and shit, when they was just showing the ranch and they had told us all the kind of fucked up shit that was going on in there, I'm watching TV like, just show us what these motherfucking monsters look like. Just show us what these hateful motherfucking creatures look like. And then they opened the doors and these motherfuckers came out like Little House on the Goddamn Prairie and shit. Just dun, 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 dun. And bitch came out with a dress made out of construction paper and leaves and shit. I laughed the whole goddamn time. I had them poor women in there, they don't know nothing about nothing. They ain't never seen Sex in the City, The Sopranos, nothing. They ain't never seen nothing. They don't know what to say in the interview. Just, we want our kids. Oh, I laughed from a good, healthy place to see white people back in colonial days again on TV. Because you know if that had been niggas, it'd have been some different shit. If they'd have found 400 nigger kids in a camp, they'd have burned that bitch down and came in with 800 SWAT teams. But because they was white, they came and got them in tour buses and shit and took them on. Dun, 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 dun. I laugh all the goddamn time. I don't give a fuck if it's right or not. I laugh first. Like when them motherfuckers got attacked by that goddamn tiger in the goddamn zoo in San Francisco and shit. And they had it all on CNN like it was a national tragedy and shit. Just, oh, it's so sad. Well, I didn't see nothing sad at all. I laughed the whole goddamn coverage. These wasn't kids, these was grown motherfuckers. I feel like if you a grown motherfucker and you get killed by a tiger, and you get killed by a tiger in a zoo, and you get killed by a tiger in a zoo in San Francisco, I think God's will has been done for your life. I think that's exactly what was supposed to happen, and I think he wanted me to laugh about it a whole lot. That's what I think. Fuck that. I'm a parent. I got kids. I feel like if you raise a child at any age that's dumb enough to climb into a tiger's cage, you should tell them the rest of the goddamn story. Then the tiger eats your asshole out, baby. That's the end. That's what the fuck's supposed to happen. And these motherfucking zookeepers got on TV and started talking shit about the tigers. Start snitching on the tigers like they was disappointed in the tigers and shit. Like, we can't believe they would even do something like that. They've never done anything like that before. And if they're a danger to the community, then we'll have to get rid of them. You gonna get rid of the tiger? You gonna get rid of the only real motherfucker in the whole goddamn equation? You gonna get rid of the tiger? First of all, white people, understand this. If you cannot understand what it's like to be a tiger in a zoo, I don't know how you ever gonna understand what it's like to be a nigga in America. If you can't understand what it's like to be a tiger in a zoo. Look at white people. What? Niggas are tigers now? They're great. Follow along, white people. All I'm saying is you got to look at this shit from the tiger's motherfucking viewpoint. First of all, this ain't no fake ass got it at the mall tiger. This a real goddamn tiger, like the kind that be on National Geographic every time you turn it on the back of a wildebeest ass and shit. Just, wildebeest don't even be dead. I'm not even dead yet. I don't give a fuck, bitch. I'm hungry now. Real fucking tiger. And every day, they got this real fucking tiger in a fake-ass habitat. Real fucking tiger, fake-ass habitat. And the tiger not supposed to know, as a real tiger, that this is a speaker system. And every fucking day, the tiger be fucked up because he be conflicted. Everything in the tiger spirit is telling him, nigga, you a motherfucking monster, nigga. You a beast. You run the jungle, nigga. You supposed to roar and shit's supposed to happen. And every fucking day, the tiger come out and tried and the shit don't work. And some of us know how to fuck that feel to be trying shit and trying shit, trying shit and trying shit, don't work. Trying shit and trying shit, won't work. Trying shit and try, switch it up. Trying shit, won't work. That's how the fuck the tiger feel every goddamn day he come out with the roar and shit. Just... wish me luck, wish me luck. Take a camera phone picture of me right in the middle of my goddamn roar. You see how they disrespect the tiger? These four tigers don't know what the fuck to do. It be four, five real tigers in a fake-ass habitat. What the fuck you think them tigers talk about every goddamn day? Nothing but what the fuck they would do if a motherfucker was to ever climb their goddamn foot over the goddamn gate. That's all the fuck they talk about. Just, I wish a motherfucker would climb in this goddamn cage. This cage right here, nigga. This cage right here, nigga. Wish a motherfucker would. And the tiger be fucked up. Because the tiger feel like he's supposed to be eating elephants and giraffes and shit. And every day they come feed him meat out of a bucket and shit. Just... and all while he eating that bullshit, what he be looking at? Your good fresh meat ass walking around the zoo with a video camera and shit. Just... look at that delicious ass fat bitch right there. I eat the shit. How that delicious ass fat bitch right there. Fuck that, it's a baby fat right on her motherfucking ass. You know that's my favorite part. I love baby fat. And the tiger be fucked up because he don't know what to feel. And after a while, he get depressed and down and start acting like us. You know how we get depressed and start doubting shit that we shouldn't even doubt. I bet the tigers had got as low as they could possibly get. Just, are you sure I'm a tiger? I don't feel very much like a tiger. Maybe I'm just a vicious-ass koala bear. Did you ever investigate that? But as a real motherfucker, you can't never afford to give up. Because all real motherfuckers is only waiting on one opportunity. And that's the opportunity to show a motherfucker they ain't bullshitting. And I bet them tigers had got as low as they could possibly get. And then something wonderful happened in the tiger world. Nigga, this is not a drill. Get ready, nigga. They think we bullshitting. Wait for it, wait for it. Molly! That's what the fuck's supposed to happen. What the fuck's supposed to happen? God damn, that tiger... that's a strong-ass wildebeest. I almost broke both of my arms. That would have fucked up all the rest of the show. I had to do it like this, poor little tank tank. My motherfucking point is, we going through some new motherfucking shit in the world. We going through some new fucking shit. And it's going to be important that you have your star player in line. Then you going to have to make sure you got your team set up. And some of us been forgetting to set up our motherfucking team. You're not going to be able to go past 2008 without your motherfucking team. You going to need three or four motherfuckers that you know for a fact will jump in and block bullshit off your motherfucking ass in a time of crisis. You going to need that shit. You going to need four, five motherfuckers will just jump in and block bullshit off of your motherfucking ass in a time of crisis. You gonna need that. The team is gonna be very, very important in this next motherfucking era we finna go into. You gonna need a team. If you don't believe me, ask Michael Vick's motherfucking ass how much you need a team. That nigga's alone, alone, alone. Everybody told on that nigga, everybody. Family, friends, co-workers, strangers. His motherfuckers in line excited to tell on this nigga. Yes, I saw him when he was 4 years old and he had two puppies with him. I just won't say that, in case that was important. These motherfuckers don't give a fuck. That's why you got to make sure your team is together, because these motherfuckers will snap on you. They'll switch on you like, I can't even fucking do it quick enough. They'll snitch. These motherfuckers will switch it up on you just like fucking that. That's right there. That was the one. If I hadn't broke my arm earlier, I could have done it correctly, but just like that, that's how fucking quick them motherfuckers will turn on you. You don't believe me? Ask Britney motherfucking Spears how quickly them motherfuckers will turn on you. Poor Britney. Poor Britney. How sad, how hilariously sad what'll happen if you ain't got your motherfucking team right. They switched on her so motherfucking quick. They was just taking sweet pictures of Britney. Just, how you doing, Britney? Looking good, Britney? You going shopping, Britney? Now they taking gangster pictures. Just get in the car, bitch. Show us your pussy, bitch. Throw your wig in the air. Wave it like you just don't care. They don't give a fuck, but you gotta watch the goddamn story. Kevin Federline is the motherfucking American dream. I hope you was watching the goddamn story. You can hate the player, but you can't hate the goddamn game. And that goddamn Kevin Federline followed the pimp manual step by goddamn step, line by motherfucking line. That motherfucker was a joy to watch. It was like he was on SportsCenter. Just da-na-na, da-na-na. Fucking Federline. This motherfucker is not bullshitting. His name gonna be an adjective in 2009. A way of warning a woman. Bitch, don't fuck around and get Federline fucking with me. I'm telling you, I am not one to play with. That motherfucker, Kevin Federline, is the American goddamn dream. He is proof that you can take nothing and turn it into something. If you don't believe me, on the count of three, name your favorite Kevin Federline moment. One, two, three. Nothing. Turned it into something. And Britney was the shit. She wasn't no regular goddamn singer. She was performing in front of arenas and shit. I got nigga kids. My kids was listening to her shit in the kitchen trying to make it cool and shit. Just, oops, I did it again. Okay, nigga, just say you sorry and go to your room. I don't need you to perform and shit. And all fucking time while Britney was out there performing, Kevin Federline's position was way back here behind the goddamn DJ and shit. He used to have to dance from back here. Just... that motherfucker got in and handled his goddamn business. And I was trying to tell all women on my staff, you better fucking watch this shit so you can see what the fuck happened. And they didn't want to fucking believe me. Just, what he gonna do? He gonna get with her and take her money? No, bitch. It looked like he gonna make his own motherfucking money. There go the babies. Check and checkmate. Right on schedule. This motherfucker is not missing a beat. Well, what he gonna do? He gonna break up with her so he can get the money? No. It looked like he gonna make her break up with her motherfucking self. And the next time you saw her, she was in the back of an ambulance looking happy and mad at the same time. That's why you gotta make sure you got your fucking team together. These motherfuckers ain't playing fair. You gonna need your team together. You don't believe me? Ask Eddie Murphy. That motherfucking bitch from the Spice Girls came from London and got that motherfucker in 3.2 minutes or some shit. Soon as she got off the plane, she was on her shit. Just, yeah, we're pregnant, Eddie, my boy. Yeah, that bitch is the shit. You gonna have to make sure your motherfucking team is right, especially us fellas. It start with us. We supposed to be the motherfucking team captains. We supposed to be the coach of our motherfucking team. And some of us have forgotten how important the team gonna be in 2008. Some of you niggas got a franchise player on your motherfucking team. I'm talking about a thoroughbred woman, one that live and die by the goddamn team. You got a franchise player and you done let her sit on the bench. She done forgot what team she even on. You gotta understand, some of you niggas ain't going to the playoffs. Some of you niggas is 3-22 in the relationship right now. You gonna have to work on it. Work on your franchise player. Some of y'all got a wonderful franchise player, but you so busy looking out at the free agency and who getting traded and who coming up on the draft. You done forgot about your franchise player. You got to fucking try. You ain't got to spend no money. You ain't got to wait for a holiday. You got to fucking try. Just wait for the right moments. Wait for her to be laying across the bed on her stomach, unsuspecting. That's a great time for a pep talk, for some enthusiasm and shit. If you just sneak up on her in the right moment. Just... You do remember whose motherfucking team you on, don't you? Huh? Do you remember whose motherfucking team you on? 2, 4, 6, 8. Who do we appreciate? Come on now. Just gonna have to do it, fellas. We gonna have to try. Some of you niggas won't even try to keep your franchise player motivated. Won't even fucking try. Some of you niggas won't even jack off. You done got so motherfucking grown, you too grown to jack off. You don't even want to practice. You won't practice at all. I don't understand how you gonna keep playing the game, nigga, if you refuse to goddamn practice. You just gonna run in the game cold, nigga? You ain't gonna warm up or nothing? Karan, tell him, don't you have to warm up? You gotta fucking warm up. This is bullshit. You got some of you fellas, come on now, goddamn it. We got to try. You want women to do all kind of shit for us. We want her to wear some new lingerie, put on a new outfit, cut her hair different, bring another girl in the relationship. I did that for 5 niggas. That's what I said. That's the one I had picked. Remember I picked that one? I'm just saying, we gotta do something, niggas. We can't just keep presenting the same dick night after night. Just dun da da da. No? Dun, da, da, dun. We gotta fucking try. Some of you niggas won't even fucking try. You not gonna jack off. And because you won't jack off, nigga, some of you grown motherfuckers have been had the same hand and your same dick your whole motherfucking life. And you don't know your own motherfucking stroke number. You don't know. You don't know your own motherfucking cum number. You don't know your own. Fuck number, fuck a sleep number, nigga. You don't know your own goddamn fuck number. You don't know how many times you can do this before something happens. You have no idea. Every time you fuck her, you playing Russian roulette. You don't know, she don't know. It's a surprise to both of you. Just bang, bang. I'm sorry. I didn't even see that coming. I would have warned you. It caught me off guard, to be honest with you. You gonna have to find out your own fuck number, nigga. It'll free you up for the rest of your goddamn relationship if you can just find out what your fuck number is. Cause if you find out it's 174, now you have taken the pressure off yourself. Cause now you ain't gotta try to get to 175. You know that's unnecessary cause you can always stop and reset at 175 now. So now you free, you just 172, 173, 174. Reset, thank you. But you want to know your own fuck number, at least, even if your number is small. Even if your number is 12, nigga, even if your number is 12, at least you should know what it is, nigga. It ain't the end of the world because your number is 12. You can still have fun with 12. You can do slow sex, fast sex. You just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, reset. Then switch it up. Just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Gotta fucking try. Some niggas gonna try. Some niggas gonna be laying across the bed. $5 foot long. You gotta fucking try is my fucking point. Some of you niggas been fucking since you was 15 and you don't have your own signature move yet. You've been fucking since you was a teenager. You ain't got your own fucking move. You still doing the same original fucking, the same OG teenager fucking. You don't have nothing. You niggas don't even have a dismount yet, nigga. A dismount is easy, nigga. At least you could get a dismount. Work on your signature move for 2008. Give your woman something special. Everybody wants something special every now and again. You don't want to go to a basketball game and just see motherfuckers doing layups all the goddamn time. That's why the WNBA is struggling like they are. You want to see a nigga do some special shit every once in a while. That's what she want too, nigga. Work on you a signature move. I got one called monkey fuck. I don't know. I don't know if it worked, but I do know if I give it to you, I'm giving her all she's got, Captain. Because once I'm in monkey fuck, everything is moving, nigga. I'm everywhere trying everything. You gotta fucking try, is my point. There's too much motherfucking shit going on in the motherfucking world. We got big time fucking issues happening in the goddamn world right the fuck now. We still got racism in America right the fuck now. 40 years after Martin Luther King's assassination, we still got racism in America right the fuck now. We gonna have to deal with it. We gonna have to fucking deal with it. White people, first of all, understand this. If you don't take nothing else from the nigga meeting, just understand this, white people. Y'all brought us over here, and y'all ain't got no motherfucking receipt. So y'all are not gonna be able to return, niggas. You need to understand that from the very beginning. Niggas are here to stay. We gotta get over certain shit. I can honestly say I'm a nigga, and I love niggas, but I don't wanna live in a country with just niggas. Fuck y'all, I don't. I have too many customer service needs and requirements that I have become accustomed to. Fuck that. Y'all know what the fuck I'm talking about. You done tried to return something to a black woman at a store and she act like she bought you that shit herself personally and shit, just embarrassing you in the store. Just, well, what the fuck is wrong with it? Never mind, bitch. I don't know why I gotta have two toasters because you mad and shit. This is ridiculous. We all need each other. America is strong because of the motherfuckers that's in it. And white people, you do not want to be in this motherfucking country without niggas and Hispanics. You do not want to be in this country by your goddamn self, especially if the terrorists come. Y'all gonna be trying to break in the hood if the goddamn terrorists come. Yeah. Let us in! You guys have got all the illegal weapons in there. Let us in! Fine, we'll clean up everybody's credit. FreeCreditReport.com. We gotta get over certain shit. If you find a white person that don't like a nigga, it catch you off guard. Like, you don't like niggas? What? Niggas is the shit. You didn't know niggas was the shit? Niggas is the shit. Why you think y'all came and got us in the first fucking place? Y'all had that big-ass boat. Y'all could have got any goddamn body. I bet y'all was excited as shit the first time y'all saw niggas. What are those? Those are cool as shit. Is that their women? What's that they're carrying on their backs? That's their ass? Let's go! Let's go! Fuck, you don't like niggas. Niggas is an American success story. You ain't gonna talk me out of my love for niggas. Niggas is the shit. Niggas went from being treated like dogs till now. That's why I keep saying the word nigga, because I want them to remember what the fuck it came from. I don't give a fuck. I'm a nigga. I trace my roots. They end up in Alabama some goddamn where. I'm proud of niggas. Niggas don't never quit. Niggas always come through the motherfucking trouble and looking better at the same time. They can't make me feel bad about niggas. I remember niggas, it just looked like niggas was just in the cotton field picking cotton. Them niggas wasn't just in the field picking cotton. Them niggas was working on skills and shit that was gonna show up generation after generation later. It just looked like they was picking cotton. They was working on shit. Picking niggas, them cotton picking niggas. We gotta get over certain shit. Like when the racists were putting them nooses on black university professors' doors and shit and hanging the nooses off of trees and shit, and I got fucking mad and put a noose on my neck and walked down the red carpet of the hip hop awards, and then them motherfuckers had me on CNN the next week like I was the racial problem in America, and they were so glad to catch me. Like, what the fuck do you, why do you think racism is so funny, Katt Williams? That's not what the fuck I was trying to say. I was trying to say niggas ain't scared of rope. That wasn't the fucking point. Niggas ain't scared of rope and knots and shit. It wasn't that. It's the fucking hanging we had a problem with. So if you not gonna hang a motherfucker, then what the fuck is you putting nooses around trying to scare some goddamn body for? I keep saying you don't see gangbangers putting bullets on the curb to scare a motherfucker. Just...
Wait till these niggas see this shit. They gonna be scared. I put two hollow points down there. Them niggas gonna be scared as shit.
Just saying, we gotta get over certain shit. That racism is still fucking out there, and we gonna have to deal with it as a motherfucking country. I didn't know it was even out there like that. I had to fuck around and get my motherfucking feelings hurt. I did Flavor Flav, Comedy Central roast and shit, and I was so excited, thank you, sir, because I was excited because it was going to be me and Flav and Samoa and Ice-T and Snoop. And I'm like, okay, this is a wonderful thing for niggas. And sometimes shit just catch you off guard. I showed up 4 days early, like, I just want to get the script so I can get my part together so I can do my job. And they was like, it's no script. You going to write yours. And then we got writers that's going to write for everybody else. Now, at this point, my nigga spider sense begins to tingle softly, like, nigga, you been in a setup before, and it feels just like this, coincidentally. So I'm worried. I keep asking about the script. They keep telling me it's no script. They tell me wait for the day before the show to the dress rehearsal. So we get to the dress rehearsal, and it's just us niggas. None of the white comics is there. I'm like, well, what about them? Don't they have to be here for the dress rehearsal so they can dress in rehearsal? They was like, no, they professionals. They do this all the time. Uh-huh. All right. Well, at this point, it's no longer tingling. Now it's a full alarm blaze right now. Some shit is really going on. So I sent D. Militant in there to find me a goddamn script. And sure enough, he come back with the script and it's racist like a 1946 newspaper. I saw the William Shatner roast and the Pamela Anderson roast, and it wasn't all about them being white. But on Flavor Flav shit, every other word was Flav is a crispity, crackly, crunchity coon. He's a black, sizzly, crunchity, crackly coon. Flavor's a big, black, crispy, crackly, crunchity coon. All through the fucking script. The first line say Flavor Flav in a purple suit and a paper hat is supposed to come out the sky on a wire with his legs cocked up like this. And as he come out the sky, the first words I'm supposed to say is, look, it's a flying monkey. That's what it say right on the first goddamn line. So I'm backstage going the fuck off. Like, it's gonna be the crispity, crackly, crunchity coon hour on my motherfucking watch. I'm tearing up all the shit in the backstage I can afford to tear up. I'd have left the plasmas and the stereo and shit, but I'm fucking up the plastic cups and paper plates and shit. Give me these napkins, nigga, I don't give a fuck. I done $11 worth of goddamn damage back there. By the time I get out, Flav is already in the contraption and they just let him go. And all I can say is, look, it's a flying monkey. That's all I can say. And the whole goddamn show, I was mad, but I was mad at me that I was still fucking doing it the way I felt. But they had already told me how much they was gonna pay me and I had already spent it in my head. So I was in a fucked up position. I was mad the whole goddamn show. And Flavor's kids was in the audience. They left halfway through the show crying and shit because they daddy had been called all types of crispity, crackity, crunchity coons. And after the show, I'm mad. My staff mad. Everybody backstage like, it's still racism in this motherfucking day and age and we feeling fucked up. And right at that moment, Flav bust in the trailer, smiling and congratulating everybody on a good show and high-fiving niggas. And I was like, what the fuck is wrong with you, nigga? You don't give a fuck what these motherfuckers think about you? And certain niggas you don't expect to learn nothing from. Like, you know what the fuck I'm saying. I'm saying if a nigga standing in front of you in a Viking helmet and gold teeth and a purple suit and a big-ass clock with the wrong goddamn time on it, you'll be like, I can't learn nothing from this nigga right here. I can't learn nothing from this nigga. And I'll never forget, that nigga looked at me, he was like, I don't give a fuck what they think. They got to pay me, boy, and ran out the goddamn trailer. got to thinking about it. You know what? That nigga is absolutely goddamn right. That's what the fuck it mean to be in tune with your star player. If they was gonna call you a crispity, crackly, crunchity coon anyway, you might as well get them motherfuckers for everything. Everything, everything. You got to be in tune with your star goddamn player. You ain't never gonna be able to please every goddamn body, and you might as well stop fucking trying. Oprah Winfrey done made $9 billion goddamn dollars, and motherfuckers still be talking shit about Oprah with you should be able to kill a motherfucker just by saying $9 billion in their direction. Just $9 billion, nigga, $9 billion. You better duck, nigga, $9 billion. Did you hear the billion? Oprah done every fucking thing good you could possibly do, and motherfucker still talks, nigga, fuck her, nigga, she don't like hip-hop. Nigga, fuck hip-hop, I don't like flute music. It didn't make me $9 billion goddamn dollars. Oprah done every fucking nice thing there was to do. Fuck me. At the end of my show, I say thank you and good night. At the end of Oprah's show, you stand up. She done put a muffin basket under your seat, 2 best-selling novels, put 3 of your kids through college without your permission and shit. Well, Oprah's in tune with her star fucking player. She know you think her name ugly. That's why she named everything Oprah. The magazine name Oprah, the show name Oprah, new network name Oprah, Gail's name Oprah, Stedman's name's Oprah. She don't give a fuck. And that's how you gonna have to be. And we finna go into some major motherfucking changes in this fucking country. And white people, please do not take it the wrong way. We do not hate y'all no fucking more. It is not your fault that y'all looked the way the people looked who did the fucked up shit to us. And we understand the difference, but we gonna have to get better as a country. White people, stop asking your black friends about OJ. We don't know nothing more about OJ than y'all goddamn do. It's 50% on either side. OJ ain't come to a nigga meeting in many a moon. We don't even send him invitations anymore. Everything is not the same. White people, what about OJ? We don't know about OJ. Most of us got niggas who really are in court and really need some leniency from a judge and shit for a motherfucker to be getting off on murder and then going to jail for anything. You're not supposed to go to jail for nothing after murder, nigga. You're not even supposed to jaywalk. You're supposed to be the last nigga to cross the street. Most of us were done with this nigga where he wrote a book where he hypothetically snitches on his goddamn self. That was very unniggardly. Nigga, what? This nigga wrote a book called What If I Would Have Done It? Nigga, what if you'd have shut the fuck up? What is you trying to... Then this nigga went to jail for some shit niggas didn't even know was a crime. This nigga went to jail for stealing his own shit. Nigga, did you go to jail for stealing a picture of you, nigga? You couldn't have got a copy at Kinko's or nothing? OJ won't even go to jail like a nigga. Every time you see OJ going to jail, he moving way too fucking quick to be going to jail. Like him and the officers is late for a meeting or something with his big ass head bopping up and down and shit. All niggas know it's only one acceptable walk to jail, nigga, and it is slow and deliberate, nigga. And all while you have your head up, you be thinking, I can't remember nobody's goddamn number by heart, nigga. This is bullshit. I ain't gonna never get out of jail, nigga. I can't remember nobody's goddamn number. This is bullshit. We just gonna have to deal with the shit we gotta deal with. Make sure you have as much fucking fun as you can. I get in trouble because I be trying to have too much fun, and I be telling black people you need to get you some white friends, but you have to be careful with your white friends. Your white friends will get you fucked up accidentally sometimes. Like, everybody know I like weed. Everybody know I think it's fantastic. Well, my white friends fucked me up on the shit because they was like, we got something that's really fantastic. And I was like, well, weed is already really fantastic. I don't know how you go out fantastic. And sometimes, niggas, you should know when to shut the fuck up, because I be saying shit like, I wonder how high I could actually get. And if you say that around some niggas, we all just laugh and move on. Just shit seriously, and they got answers for your questions and shit, and you might want to be careful and shit, because my white friends introduced me to something called the vaporizer. And as a public service announcement, niggas, this is... This is the real deal right here. This is a lot of shit is bullshit. This is not one of them, nigga. This is Star Trek The Next Generation right here. This is a new frontier. I was not fucking ready. It come in a black box and shit, and you put the weed in there, and then they plugged it in the wall. Now, soon as I saw them plug it into the wall, I realized I had already crossed my motherfucking boundary. I'm standing there with a lighter in my motherfucking hand like, this motherfucker is no bullshit. It got real knobs on it. You don't put it on warm. It's like an oven. You put it on a real temperature, like 375, like Jiffy Corn Muffin Mix numbers. And it ain't got no fire and no smoke, which really fuck with me, because if you smoke weed, the smoke is your way of knowing when not to go too far. You can't really go too far, because when you've achieved maximum highness, your lungs will let you know. That's when you can't catch the cough. When you... But this don't have no smoke. It's just all vapor, and you have to be careful, because you don't know how many vapors you can safely take. You just don't know. I was 4 or 5 bags in before I realized, nigga, you have made a terrible mistake. You, this shit, you might not want to find out how high you can actually get. Just take it from me. You might really embarrass yourself to yourself if you ain't careful. You don't want to be a grown motherfucking man in your own car in the driveway with a wife beater on and some jogging pants, crying with a lap full of bills, crying to Lil Wayne songs and shit, because he sound like he's 6 when he rapping. You just in the car, just, if I don't do nothing, I'm a ball. I count all day like a couple of good you buddy, just a bad boy. Look in the left mirror, I ain't never read from the dick, I had that damn joy. Just saying, you might not want to get to that motherfucking extreme. That shit got so high, it took me all the way low, and then took me all the way high. And you're not supposed to be so high that you go in your house and start fucking with your kids' Wii game. You are not supposed to do it, because Wii and weed do not go together. They seem like they should go together, but they don't, because the Wii wants you to be active, and weed wants you to sit your motherfucking ass down, and you should not be fucking with that. You are not supposed to, as a grown man, get so high that you done went in the house, found your kids' Wii, trying to play tennis in your living room and shit. Move the couch! Kids come back home, what happened, daddy? It looked like a tornado came through here. Little Wayne was in here crying and shit. I don't know what the fuck happened, I'm sorry. You just gonna have to fucking do your fucking best and try as hard as you can, because sometimes shit just does not work out the way you motherfucking plan. That's just a part of life. Sometimes shit do not work out the fucking way you plan. I'm gonna give you a prime example. I waited my whole fucking life trying to get a motorcycle. My whole fucking life, all I wanted was a motorcycle. And first, I couldn't afford the motorcycle. Then when I could afford the motorcycle, then I had kids. And you can't just get a motorcycle as your primary means of transportation if you got kids. You don't know what to tell them in the driveway. You just, I ain't got no room. And I finally was able to fucking get the motorcycle. I was happy like a kid at motherfucking Christmas. You don't understand. I have never been this goddamn happy. I had the motherfucking motorcycle, and it was small and black and fast, just like me. And I had got the black Harley Davidson boots and the leather one piece that zip up here, and got the knee pads and shit already in it. I look like a black toddler superhero. Like, you should call me to solve small crimes and shit. But I felt good than a motherfucker, because I'm not that big in regular life, but on a motorcycle, nigga, I'm the perfect size. If you look in the rear view, you don't even see me coming, nigga. It just look like a bike is coming by itself, nigga. And I was so motherfucking proud to have that motherfucker, and I thought everybody was gonna be excited for me, because I was happy, and everybody talked shit. everybody. Everybody who saw me standing by the goddamn bike, talk shit about, nigga, what the fuck is you doing with a bike, nigga? You gonna kill yourself. And then my bodyguard who ride a Harley every goddamn day, I'm thinking this nigga gonna have my back. This the first nigga talking shit, talking about, nigga, if you ride, nigga, you gonna fall. Nigga, what? Nigga, if you ride, nigga, you gonna fall. Nigga, why are you saying that like that's in the Bible or something? That's not a scripture, nigga. You can't just be quoting that to people. Nigga, if you ride, nigga, you gon' fall. So he done said this shit so much, it done spooked me. So I had to take the bike off to myself for a couple days and try to practice and shit, because I'm not built like regular motherfuckers. Like, most motorcycle niggas, if you see them at the light, they holding their whole bike up just on their tippy toes and shit. I'm not built like that. I got to ease way up on the handlebars, put my legs out firmly and shit, or else I'd be done lost control of the bike and rolled into the intersection or some shit. So I had to go off to my motherfucking self and try to get my shit in fucking order. So I done worked on it for like 3 or 4 days, and finally I feel comfortable enough to debut and showcase me and my motherfucking fast ass black motherfucking bike. So we are in Tampa, and it's the perfect situation. It's a curvy road that go like this, and then it break into a straight shot for a mile. Now I'm not gonna fuck with the curvy part, but I am in the cusp of the curb and the straightaway, and all I'm waiting for is the bus to come, because it's got glass windows, and I want them to come around and then catch me in all my motherfucking glory down the goddamn street. And I'm not telling my bodyguard, because I want him to be the first motherfucker with the dusty mouth for talking shit about me in the first goddamn place. So this is how it was in my head. Now you know what I was thinking in my head. Now, it had been raining for a couple days before this day. Don't worry, that don't have nothing to do with the story. I'm just trying to make sure you know the details. But since it had been raining, I decided I'm gonna be extra careful. So I moved my bike to the middle of the street, right on the yellow line. And the reason I'm doing that is because it's a straight shot, and I wanna make sure if somebody come from this way or that way, I can fucking maneuver. Now, you can probably hear some niggas grumbling and laughing in the back. Them is real motorcycle riders who is telling their friends, you should never ever be on the yellow line, because that's the slipperiest place on the goddamn street. But none of them smart ass niggas was there at the goddamn time, so I'm just gonna tell the story like the fuck it happened. So, here I am on the yellow line. The bus is coming through the curves. Now, you know when you get excited how everything slow down and go into slow motion and shit? That's where the fuck I was. I saw the bus, I went into slow motion. And I hit that motherfucker one time. Now, let me pause the story right here. Just to say, sometimes shit does not work out the way you goddamn planned it. 1 second, I'm waiting on my moment of glory. Shoo! I hit it one time, yeep. I don't know what happened the next second. But the second after that, I am in the middle of the goddamn street with my bike on top of me. Now, not only am I in the middle of the goddamn street, trapped under my own goddamn bike, the bus has now pulled up right the fuck here. So now everybody in my staff is looking at me trapped under my own goddamn bike. And my bodyguard, who could have easily picked this motherfucker up off of me, is too busy getting his 7 goddamn chuckles under his goddamn helmet and shit. And not only am I caught under my own fucking bike, my left hand is caught up under the handlebars, so not only am I trapped under my own bike in the middle of the street, I am slowly spinning for no goddamn reason at all. Just, I get up, all this side is all crispity, crackly, crunchity, cool. I can't even get no motherfucking sympathy from no goddamn body, cause it ain't like I got in a motorcycle accident. All the fuck that happened is my bike drugged me 5 feet up the goddamn highway and then slowly spun me rotisserie style in front of my goddamn friends. I had to do what any real motherfucker would do in that situation. I got back on that motherfucker and made them follow me for 500 miles while I did 2.5 miles an hour crying, nigga. Y'all been all that. I've been Katt Williams. Thank you so much, DC. I appreciate it.
Suckers don't fit like gangsters playing ping pong. I stand strong, ain't nothing you can do with me. Billy D niggas, don't be acting like you cool.
I got my swag right, shit. I got my cash on. Shit.
A lot of haters talking about
I ain't gonna last long,
but that's
unlikely.
And they don't
like me,
cause I'ma blow,
blow,
I'ma blow,
blow.
And when I blow,
blow,
don't be acting like you cool with me. Blow,
blow,
I'ma blow.
Yeah.
I hear him talking.
Yeah, I hear.
It sound like hate.
What it sound like?
It smell like hate.
What it smell like?
It feel like hate.
It feel like what?
But ain't nothing they can do about it.
It ain't nothing they
can do. It looks like Katt know how to make good decisions.
Yeah.
Like records, people.
Woo!
Sucker ass niggas talking about they can rap.
Rap. Rap what?
They got flow.
Flow what?
Y'all got a problem is what y'all got right now.
A real problem.
Clutching explicit, people.